So let's take a look at ingredients first. We have 2 to 3 tablespoons of ghee, few garam masala, which is tejpatta. I have jeera, I have badi ilaichi, the regular ilaichi, some cloves, some dalchini there. Then we have ginger garlic paste. We have about 2 spoons of curd. I have some boiled rice, some sliced onions, some chopped green chilies, some sliced tomatoes, and the vegetable of your choice. So I have taken paneer, mushroom, and flour, and I have taken some green peas and some potatoes. But you can add vegetables as per your choice. In spices, we have some salt as per taste, some haldi powder, some Kashmiri lal mirch powder. This is because it gives a little more better color to the vegetable. If you don't have this, it's completely optional. You can use your regular chili powder. I have some crushed kasuri methi. I have some amchur powder. I have some jeera powder. I have some coriander powder. And for garnishing of our biryani, we have some fried onions, some fried cashew nuts, some chopped coriander leaves and mint leaves, and I have some kesar which I have mixed in milk. This is completely optional. It just gives a good flavor. That's why I am using it. If you don't have it, you can skip this. We'll start by heating a pan and adding about 2 tablespoons of ghee in this. Let the ghee melt completely. The ghee is nice and hot. Now let's add all our garam masalas to this. And we will just saute this for about 2 minutes so that all of these gets fried properly. Now add the chopped onions to this. We will also add in the green chilies that we had chopped and the ginger garlic paste. Give this a nice mix and allow this to fry till onions are like translucent. We have to cook this till onions are translucent and also till the ginger garlic raw flavor goes away. These have become a little transparent. Now we are adding our tomatoes to this. Saute this for another like about 2 minutes till the tomatoes are a little soft. The tomatoes have become a little soft. Now we'll add in all the other vegetables that we had kept. Give this a nice mix. Let this cook in just the oil for a while. We are now going to add all our spices into this. And then give this a nice mix so that the spices are coated on all the vegetables. Now allow this to cook for a while. These are fried for a while. Now we are going to add some curd, about say 2 tablespoons of curd to this. Mix this with the masalas. Now we are going to cover this and cook this for a while. You can also add in a little water if you think it's very dry and may stick to the pan. These are cooked and they look really lovely. Now let's start the plating. I have taken a bowl here for plating. Basically, you can use any bowl which you can put it back on gas again. I have greased this with a little bit of ghee in it. And now I'm going to make a layer by adding these vegetables to this pot at the end. So I've added it and I'm just going to like spread a little and make a base of layer for this. Flatten this a little bit. And that's it. We'll add our boiled rice on the second layer. So basically while boiling this rice, guys, I had added a little ghee and salt to this so that this is not completely bland. We will add this as a second layer of our biryani. There you go. And we're just going to flatten this with the help of a spoon. This is how it looks. And now I'm going to add my ghee to this, the leftover one that we have a little left from when we were cooking the vegetable. I'm just going to add this on top of this hot rice. And just spread this over slightly. because when we reheat this, guys, the ghee will like seep into the biryani and it will taste really nice. That's why I'm doing this step. Now I'm gonna add kesar to this biryani, which I said is optional, but if you adding it, this is a stage that you will have to go ahead and add this. Now I'm gonna cover this and put this on the gas again for the rice and the gravy to be heated together so that it gets mixed and the flavors come out really well of ghee and kesar as well. And of course, guys, biryani does not taste well when it's not served with raita. So till the time our biryani is getting hot again, I'll quickly show you an easy raita recipe in which I have curd, I have grated cucumber, I have some chopped coriander leaves, I have some salt, chili powder, roasted jeera powder, I have some black salt and some sugar. Sugar's optional, I like to add it. If you don't, you can skip it. The recipe is quite easy, guys. You mix all of these ingredients in a bowl and that's ready. Here I have added all of them. Now let's just give this a nice mix and mix all of it. I'm finding the consistency a little thick. I like it a little medium thick, so I'm gonna add in little water. This is optional, depending on the consistency you want to keep for your raita. This is ready. Let's take a look at our biryani again. You can literally smell the ghee out of this. Now I'm gonna add our fried onions on top of this as a garnish. Spread it a little. Add some cashew nuts on top of it. I had fried these cashew nuts in a little ghee. And now I'm gonna add a lot of coriander leaves on this. Coriander gives a really nice flavor, guys. I have also added mint leaves to this while chopping them. So here, guys, your biryani is ready and so is the raita. I've added the details to the description box. In case any queries, you can also write to me. If you've liked my recipe, don't forget to like and comment below and also subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon to get updates whenever I post a new recipe. See you soon again in the kitchen of Prep Cook Live.